So, I'm going to show you how to make cannagar molds. These are stuff that you could buy for a couple bucks and sell for double the price. There's like one more piece, but who cares? So anyways, what you do, get you this, right? It's like 3/4 inch finger fit in there. Thread it. Take this shit off, obviously. You don't need that anymore. That's trash. But I would suggest this part, you need a wrench. You're also gonna need some rotary blades and your friendly Dremel, bitch.
Don't lose the nut or the washer. Maybe you want to get that out as well. So obviously clear your work area. And this cuts impeccably well, so what I do, find the seam, and I bore it. That's easy. You see, it's already cutting through. That's just an evil. And it cuts right through. Didn't see straight through. And you just flip it on the other side. You want to make sure you cut it. So the way I do that, the way I make sure I cut it straight through, so I took it through there and I matched that way, right? Because it's a straight cut all the way through. Then I'm gonna go to this side. I'll make it, stick it in the hole and make it match that way too. And see, now I got a start and an end right there. I don't know if y'all can see this shit. I'm gonna clamp this bit back down. Yeah. So that's like, that's it. Then, you take your two pieces, you shove them together. You put one piece on that way. I got these upside down. Put it on the back, sit on something flat, screw the top on. Then screw the other side up. Alright. So now what you do is, let me get the band down. So then you go get the skewer. There we call it skewers, but good cook. That's not fun. And what you do is, you drop. Okay. So, what I suggest is you take a nug of marijuana and you put it on the piece, right? Well, like an inch on, you skewer through a piece of bud, right? So then you stick the bud in there, right? Okay, now I gotta get this last piece. So, let's see. Make sure you keep the stick center. You know what I'm saying? I'll do a real demo on it later on. And then once you pack that shit down, I mean, you gotta pack that shit. You gonna screw this shit. You gonna screw this shit. I'm gonna fucking be on my own stick. Yep, that's pretty much it. Shit costs like $4 a piece. And you can roll up fat. I mean, when I make cannagars, they be them motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? I don't put the most exotic weed in those. These are for like the long smoke. You want to smoke them up for hours. That's what you get these for. Alright. So that was the 3/4 by 4 inch, which will roughly get you about a 1/2 ounce blunt that will smoke. So the blunt gonna be like the size of a backwood, but fatter. This I think is gonna be about 1 ounce. My plan is to pack a cannagar in there. Instead of this one, $300, $200. So I'm stupid. Alright, let me make the smaller one. So this is like the. You know what I'm saying? This. What's in there? So with this part, this, we do it a little bit different. I get a knife, a torch. I'm gonna do the cup of the hole. Get that shit dead center. You know what I'm saying? Why we do that? Because now we got a place for our stick. You feel me? Actually, we might just pull it up before we fuck it again. But basically, we're back to the cutting board. So there's seams in these pipes, right? I don't know if you can see it like that. So there's a seam right here. And then, of course, opposite is the exact same thing. That's what we're going to hit right now. Easier. You do need to ask it for that shit. suggest that you run a knife. You know, just some scrape out any extra bullshit. Because we're about to put your weed in here. Okay. Real quick demo of why all this shit is even of any use. The short pipe is perfect for the first pipe. For the backwood. Yeah, short pipe is perfect for the backwood.
So this is what you do. You get you some of your good quality herbal essence. You know what I'm saying? And you, I suggest you put this one in there. How you do this? And just shake it up and stuff it. Tell you, it gets messy. You want to make sure you clean up all that dust shit that you was chopping up earlier. You want to smoke the plastic. That's how you find out if it's fucked up. It is fucked up. And you can just stuff somewhere on that side and fix it. This takes a lot of weed, man. I'm not playing with a little. So this is just for demonstration purposes. I'm showing you what, normally you would fill it all the way the fuck up, right? Unscrew that. Unscrew this. And then you just open that out up. You see that? So we got that part done. Now you gotta do the hard part.
Gotta roll that shit, bro.
I'm gonna teach you real quick, real simple. Get you the big leaf and play with it. You just roll the whole thing up like that. Put the plastic in there and everything. You lick it. Boom. You like that shit. Once this shit get to smoking, nigga, every nigga in the hood gonna know you with the shit. So, usually you let this shit sit and dry for a long time. We ain't got all day for that. And this is for me. Take it out the mold. If it wants to come out. Boom. So usually you just let this sit dry, but like I said, this is for me. So what you do is you just squeeze this in and you just slide, pull out. I don't know if y'all can see that shit. I just slid this out, right? And then I like to take whatever shit's at. Okay, well, I don't see my scissors that are always right here. And then, you know, the number one rule of all blunt smokers is torch time. You can never light your blunt. unfortunately not going to be sitting here through the whole smoking of this. My table on fire. Can't see the hole. Yo, hit me up. I'll sell you these things.